Hey, Fantasy Bookers. Let's do a sneak preview for my upcoming alternative history mods for Total Extreme Wrestling. We have the November of 1993 called Impact is Imminent. We also have January of 1994, Cause for Conflict. The background is What If the Blackburn Scissor Fight between Arn Anderson and Sid Vicious never happened. So the main storyline for Starrcade 1993 is the World Heavyweight Champion Vader versus his former Masters of the Powerbomb Bash brother Sid Vicious. So let's go back to September of 1993. The Fall Brawl Big War Games match. In this timeline, we have Sting, Davey Boy Smith, Dustin Rhodes, and Road Warrior Hawk defeating Vader, Sid Vicious, and Harlem Heat. So this means no Shockmaster since Hawk was never injured. So Fred Ottman isn't available on the roster. He was never hired. The same with the retarded Evad. No equalizer. Who's that? Never heard of that guy. No one actually listened to Rick Rude. So no jabroni, retarded Dave Evad Sullivan was hired. He is somewhere in the Indies. So, in the November version, we will have the chance to build the big feud between Vader and Sid Vicious. Sid Vicious will be the face, while in the January version, Sid Vicious will start as the world champion after defeating Vader at Starrcade. We also have the Hollywood Blondes in the November 1993 version. This will be the last chance to keep Steve Austin and Brian Pillman as a tag team, or you can of course split them up and begin the feud. While in the January version, Austin and Pillman are feuding, and Steve Austin is aligned with Colonel Robert Parker, also known as the KFC, Kentucky Fried Chicken. So let's check out some other starting storylines. We have another major timeline flashpoint created for this mods. In the World Wrestling Federation, we have the Lex Express. So this means that Lex Luger did defeat Yokozuna at SummerSlam and will start as the world champion. The feud is still active. So it's Lex Luger versus Yokozuna and the Finnish badass Ludwig Borga. Some other starting storylines is actually Too Cold Scorpio, Marcus Alexander Bagwell versus the Pretty Wonderful. So as you can see, Orndorff is tagging with Pizza Paul Roma. So this means no Pizza Paul in the Horseman. Some other active storylines are Cactus Jack, Max Payne versus the Nasty Boys. I'm really looking forward to book this feud myself and to book some nice hard-hitting hardcore matches during the spring of 1994 between these two tag teams. Some minor feuds. We have Ice Train versus former world champion Ron Simmons. And we also have Rick Rude feuding with Davey Boy Smith. So take a look at the roster of World Championship Wrestling. This means that we have Davey Boy Smith, we have DDP, we have Dustin Rhodes, we have Lord Steven Regal, we have Rick Rude, we have Ricky Steamboat, we have Road Warrior Hawk on the roster, we also have The Boss, also known as Ray Trailer, Big Boss Man. We also have Sting. And we have the opportunity, if we look at the starting absences, Hulk Hogan on is filming Thunder in Paradise. But we will have the chance to sign the major free agent during the spring of 1994. Or we keep the traditional World Championship Wrestling and don't sign Hogan. The roster is pretty stacked and talented. If we take a look at the tag teams, some other tag teams are Bobby Eaton teaming with Chris Benoit, a super talented blue chipper tag team. We also have Harlem Heat and the Horsemen. Yes, we actually have a really good Horsemen tag team consisting of Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard. So the Horsemen, we have Ric Flair, Arn, Tully, and we have Bryant Anderson as a minor associate member instead of Pizza Paul. Some other content in the database is actually worker relationship. There are lots of added relationships based on information available online, information available on various wrestling podcasts and wrestling books. And expect the number to increase as I continue to work on the mod. The mod is maybe around 45% done at the moment. So this number will increase. Same with the number of tag teams. I have added a lot of tag teams to help the not so bright TEW AI to use the real tag teams instead of inventing fantasy tag teams. So there will be a lot of added data into the tag teams folder of the database. And this will, of course, continue to increase as I add new data. We also have lots of locations as I am using my upcoming venue database. Let's take a look. All venues have venue descriptions, so it's easy to see if it's a indoor or outdoor venue. I've also added reputations for all venues, to help the AI select the realistic venues. Wrestling hotbeds have been preset. Same with the opening and closing dates. So no more all venues being opened in 1950. I adjusted all opening dates. I've also added the hard close option. So this venue database will be compatible with all historical mods. So expect a lot of venues to opening and also to hard close during gameplay. I've also added a lot of confirmed future arena projects. So we will have some future venues being added later on during gameplay. So you can also use this venue database with current day mods or future mods. I'm also using my broadcaster database, the latest version that haven't been officially released yet. So a lot of content here, and I'm still gonna add update the broadcaster database and add new stuff to it. And as we can see here, we also have lots of chemistry added. Since I really hate when established tag teams get poor or very poor chemistry by randomness. So most of these chemistries are neutral chemistries, but some of the best tag teams obviously have preset good, or in a few cases even great chemistry. Same with the wrestlers. So let's take a look here. Sting and Lex Luger, teaming with Lex Luger, have preset good chemistry instead of going for the random, as I really hate the poor and awful randomness. So I will continue to work on this mod, adding new stuff, hopefully finish it as soon as possible so I can release it. So thanks for checking out this video.